Hello and welcome back to video classes by Kannur English Medium School. Today we will be discussing the poem Tiger. Now before we start, I want to ask you, do you know what endangered animals are? Yes, endangered. Do you understand this term? Endangered. What is an endangered animal? Well, an endangered animal is an animal which is at the risk of becoming extinct in the near future. Yes, endangered animals become extinct. They become extinct. What is meant by extinct? Extinct is losing existence. If an animal dies out and is no longer in existence, then we call that animal an extinct animal. So endangered animals are at the risk of becoming what? Extinct in the near future. So something needs to be done to protect them, otherwise the last remaining of that animal species will be lost, right? This is the concept of classifying an animal as endangered. Now why does this happen actually? Why animals become endangered? Well, it's not just because of human activity. There are some natural factors involved as well. But yes, it's mainly because of human activities. So we can attribute this phenomenon to three factors. First one, habitat loss. What is it? Habitat loss. So one of the reasons, one of the factors for an animal to become extinct is loss of its habitat. So habitat refers to the natural living area or space for the animal. So because of natural as well as man-made factors, animals lose their natural habitat and that causes them to become endangered and then later on extinct. And also poaching, this is where human involvement is directly involved, yes? Poaching is illegal hunting. And another reason for animals to become endangered or extinct is because of what is known as invasive species. Invasive species are other animals that invade the living space of one animal and then cause problems for that animal and its population decreases. So these are the three important reasons why an animal becomes extinct. And today we are talking about tiger, and tigers are classified as endangered animals. Today there are only about 4,000 tigers living in the world. Only 4,000. Do you know what this number was like 100 years ago? It was more than 1 lakh, that is 100,000, more than 100,000. From more than 100,000, the number of the population of tigers has decreased so much, and today we have only 4,000 of them. We're not talking about the tiger population in India or any particular country. We are talking about tiger population in the entire world. So that 4,000 is very precious for us. If we lose any more tigers, then very soon this endangered animal will become extinct. So there are people and organizations and governmental agencies who are trying very hard to protect and increase the number of tigers. So this poem is dedicated to the situation tigers are found these days. This poem is written by a very well-known Indian writer by the name K.K.N. Daruwala. Right, let's read the poem and then see what it tells us about tigers. The tiger isn't burning bright either in shadow or in sun. That's how the poem opens for us. The tiger isn't burning bright. What is burning bright? This phrase has been taken from a William Blake poem. Yes, William Blake is another well-known writer, a poet. He has written a poem called Tiger, Tiger, Burning Bright. So from that, K.K.N. Daruwala has taken the line and then he has extended that poem to give a different idea. So he says, the tiger isn't burning bright. So what does it mean when we say burning bright? Well, it refers to the golden and black stripes on a tiger's body that shimmer, right? They have a certain glow about them. So they look wonderful, they look majestic, and fears as well. That's what we that's what refers to when we say burning bright. So the poet says the tiger is not burning bright. That means the glory of the tiger has diminished. It's not because the tigers have lost their strength. It's not because of that, but it's because their numbers are dwindling, they are declining. So this animal that ruled the jungles once upon a time is now living at a great risk of becoming extinct. That is what is meant by the tiger is not burning bright. The tiger is not burning bright either in shadow or in the sun, whether in shadows of the jungles or in the open field or the open jungle under the bright sunshine. The tiger is not burning bright anymore. The tiger family is thinning. Yes, there is a mistake in the poem as given in your textbook. The word given there is thinking, so you need to strike it out and replace it with thinning, thinning, thinning means becoming thin. So we are talking about the tiger population becoming declining, it's becoming thin. 2 by 2 and 1 by 1, so 1 by 1, 2 by 2, the population has seen a declining trend. The tiger isn't burning bright. Again, in the second verse, we open with the same line. The tiger isn't burning bright in the forests of the night or in the wilderness of the day. So whether it is day or night in the jungles, the tigers, they used to roam without fear. Yes, such fierce creatures they were. But now they are living in fear. They were fearless. Now they are living in fear because of a lot of things that are happening around them in their environment, which is causing their numbers to come down. So, or in the wilderness of day, we need to understand his plight. His refers to the tiger, and the plight means condition. Yes, living condition. We need to understand in what condition this wonderful animal is living these days. Yes, when we say that, that means these animals are living in pathetic conditions, in miserable conditions these days, because they're exposed to constant danger because of human activity. Now, although I said there are 3 different factors for an animal becoming endangered or later on extinct, among those 3 factors, I had mentioned human activity, that is poaching, illegal hunting, being one of the factors. In this poem, we are talking about that human activity, that is illegal hunting. So, the tiger has to live in fear of man these days because man can use technology, he can use rifles, and he can easily kill these wonderful animals. So, in such pitiful state, these tigers are living. The father, Sheru, is missing now. Sheru has been shot and skinned. K.M. Darwala, the poet, talks about one particular tiger. He calls the tiger Sheru. Of course, that comes from Sher, from Hindi, which means tiger. The father Sheru is missing now. Say, there is a family, there's a small family of tigers, and the male, the dominating male of the family, the father who has cubs, yes, in the family, he's gone, he's missing, he has not come back. It's late already, and he's not come back. What has happened to him? Well, he's been shot and skinned. The poachers, these illegal hunters, they have killed him. And the family doesn't know that he's dead. He's been killed and his skin has been removed because tiger skin is very valuable, yes? It has got a huge demand in black market too. So tigers are killed because of their skin. His skin has been removed and then that's it, he's dead. Poachers ground his bones to powder for some Chinese medicine. Well, there is a belief that the powder of tiger's bones, yes, has a medicinal value. It's a belief, it's not proven. And because of that, some stupid belief, people kill tigers and their bones are used in preparing medicine, some Chinese medicine, right? So, how miserable is this? We don't even know whether the bones have medicinal value, just blind belief, and because of that belief, the tigers have to pay with their lives. Bones would bring them power, they thought. put life into some sickly man. Their souls were sick. Killing tigers is something we won't understand. Well, somebody said tiger bones are good because they have medicinal values, they can cure sick people. And somebody said that, and then that became a trend, and tigers started getting killed. And now their bones became, they started having a price in the market for that medicinal thing. So, and because of that, we are killing tigers? Is this something we should not understand? Well, how stupid is it to kill tigers for some blind belief? That is a question mark at the end of that sentence. His skin is hanging on a wall, his bones are packed in a plastic wallet and shipped out. Well, what has happened to the skin? Somebody purchased his skin. Father Shamu's skin, that is. Somebody purchased it in the market and now they have put it on the wall as a decoration in their house. And it's hanging there. That's Father Shamu's skin. What happened to his bones? Well, his bones have been packed for medicine, of course, preparation of medicine, and they have been shipped out. Shipped out means they have been sent out for trade, yes. And a gecko on the wall is hunting insects on his hide. And that skin that's hanging on the wall, there is a lizard. Gecko refers to a lizard, a house lizard. And this lizard is, you know, moving around the tiger skin. See, what an irony there we see in that picturization, yes. Imagine a tiger skin on the wall and a lizard, you know, moving around it. What does it indicate? That tiger, such powerful animal, is now helplessly there, and then its skin is hanging on the wall. So much that even a lizard can take liberty moving around it freely. Yeah, that's what it means. Once the jungles have trembled at his roar, this same tiger skin belonged to that animal, that Sheru, Father Sheru, who was so powerful, so big and huge, that one roar used to cause the jungle to tremble. All animals would be trembling with fear hearing his roar. That's how powerful, how loud his roar was. Tree tops flew up, birds disappeared. Every time he roared, trees would shake, and birds sitting in the trees, they would fly away terrified. Monkeys would scream because they were terrified too. What an uproar. Uproar refers to a state of noise, commotion and confusion. So one roar by Father Sheru would create such an uproar. Everybody would be terrified and there would be a state of confusion. Animals would scream, birds would fly away, and that tiger is now dead. Now geckos nibble on his ear, his skin is hanging on the wall, and lizards, you know, they bite the skin of that Father Sheru, that tiger, because it's just the skin, it's not Sheru himself. Well, in such a sorrowful, pitiful state, Sheru died. Lord God had stamped upon his skin in equal stripes both night and dawn. Yes, God had created such a wonderful animal and we killed it because of some stupid belief and because of making money, we killed that animal. Yes, how wonderfully God had painted his skin with a bright yellow and black stripes. His black and gold won't shimmer now. Those stripes are now, they belong to a dead skin, right? They won't have that shine, they don't have that glow anymore. Boar hunter, forest king is gone. Animals would be terrified by him. By seeing him, they would run away and he would kill even strong animals, right? He was the king of the jungle and now he's dead. So this poem talks about the pitiful condition that tigers are living in the jungles these days. Like I said, there are only about 4,000 tigers remaining alive, and it's all our responsibility. It's everybody's responsibility to make sure that that number grows, it increases, right? With that awareness, we study this poem, and that's all about this poem. Go through it, find meanings for words that you did not understand, and then we will discuss questions and answers later. So I will see you in the next class.